I speak to you in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. As a child growing up in Barbados, I often heard, and you probably have also, that God does not give us more than we can bear. You ever heard that before? Or maybe you have heard, God does not give us more than we can handle. Heard that too, right? But as I got older, and hopefully wiser, I started wondering, if God doesn't give us more than we can bear, or more than we can handle, would we necessarily need Him? If God doesn't give us more than we can bear, or more than we can handle, would we necessarily need Him? And not that I think God does this, but there are times when we cannot handle or bear certain things. And it seems to me that we would have no need of God or for Him if there weren't things that we couldn't bear, if there were not things that we couldn't handle. We will be able to get by on our own. Nevertheless, I realize that we do need God, for there are times and conditions in life that are unbearable, situations we cannot handle on our own. And so we need Him. We need Him all the time, but particularly in those unbearable situations, for it is He who makes them bearable for us. It is He who makes us capable to handle the rough patches in our lives. And if we would only seek Him in prayer, or by reading what the Scriptures say about handling such situations or circumstances, these unbearable times can become bearable. And in today's Gospel reading, Jesus told His disciples that I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. And these words form part of Jesus' final teaching to His disciples, which He gave to them while in the room on that first Monday, Thursday night. He had just finished washing their feet and eaten supper with them, which was supposed to be a Passover meal, but was more like the Eucharist. Nevertheless, Jesus' life on this earth as a human being was coming to an end, and He was encouraging His disciples. He had been with them for the past 3 years, living with them, teaching and preaching with them, eating and drinking with them, and loving them. And He healed the sick for them to see, and He performed miracles for them to experience. And now He was about to demonstrate His ultimate love by dying on a cross in their place and in our place. And yet they still did not fully understand all that Jesus was telling them, in the same way that we too do not fully understand. What they did know was that this man named Jesus was different. They saw the truth in His words and in His every being. He truly exemplified the Son of God who came from the Father, and they wished to be a part of that. But now He was about to leave them. And they were wondering, how could they accomplish what He had done and what He said, now that He was leaving them to continue His ministry? And they must have been scared out of their wits. They must have felt like asking Jesus, what is it you want us to do, Jesus? You want us to do what? And you tell us that you still have many things to say to us, but we cannot understand or cannot bear them now? That this Holy Spirit person, whoever He is going to guide us into all truth, for He will not speak on His own, but will speak whatever He hears. and he will declare it to you, the things that are to come. And I'm sure I can hear the disciples wondering or saying to Jesus, are you sure, Jesus, you really want us to continue this ministry? But our Lord knew their limitations as he knows our own limitations, which is why the Holy Spirit needed to come to fill the gap he was about to leave physically. What they could not do, Jesus will continue to do, not in the flesh, but through the power of the Holy Spirit, who will guide and lead us into all truth. For he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. So my friends, the things they could not bear would eventually become bearable through the power of the Spirit. We all experience unbearable moments in our lives. I remember 3 years ago, I received the news that I knew would one day come, but wished it would not come too soon. And that was that I would receive a phone call one day that one of my parents had died. And that day did come, and it was my dad. And I remember being in a Jamaican restaurant for breakfast when the news came by a phone call, and I just ran out of the building, out of the restaurant, bawling my head off. I had always wondered, how was I ever going to bear that news, knowing how close I am to both of my parents. And it would happen again, and many of you know this, it would happen again when my second mom died 2 years ago. And these were all unbearable moments. But it was by asking the Holy Spirit, to asking God to be with me through these situations that made them bearable for me. And every one of us have probably been through moments and times like these. We have had experiences that were more than we were able to handle. And such moments and times and experiences may have come in form of losing a job, or financial stability, or being diagnosed with a serious illness, or the loss of our home, or the end of a marriage, or the loneliness of growing old or being old, or the addiction of a child, or the death of a loved one. And there are other painful experiences in which we thought we couldn't or think we cannot bear or handle. And as we found ourselves wondering how or if we will ever get through them. And somehow we did. Maybe not as quickly as we would have liked, but we did. All because of the Holy Spirit. And he is the one who intervenes and shares the journey with us as we cry out to God in prayer. But we also tend to think of the word unbearable in a negative sense. But sometimes unbearable does not mean to be negative. There are other unbearable moments that come or could come in the form of the birth of a child, or acquiring a new home, or maybe you have gotten a job promotion in your company. And these things come with additional responsibility. Right, Tracy? Right, Misha? They come with additional responsibilities that can make life more difficult and unbearable. So much so that sometimes we risk our lives. We're back to being the same as they were before. That's why children return home. You know that. That's why children return home. For young persons, particularly teenagers, cannot wait to run off to college, to leave their parents' home, until they realize that all that glitters is not necessarily gold. When you're out in the world on your own, and reality sets in, and you realize that the buck stops at us and the responsibilities which we never had because our parents had the responsibility now become a reality. And it can become unbearable. And so they return home and they want back their own room again. Oftentimes, my friends, it is the unbearable moments that awaken us to God's presence in our lives. It is those unbearable moments that make us realize we are nothing without God. It is when we cannot handle certain things that we are reminded of our dependence on God, that we need God as Father and Son and Holy Spirit to help us. Yes, it is those unbearable moments, both the positive ones and the negative, that shows us that God is real and present if only we would let Him into our lives. It is those times, the times that are unbearable, the things we cannot handle, that God is oftentimes right there with us than we could ever imagine. And if the feast of the Holy Trinity, which we celebrate today, and is a mystery too difficult to totally put into words, if that is to have any real meaning to us, that meaning would be that we do not have to bear the unbearable alone. That the unique relationship which exists between the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is about sharing. Sharing who they are as Creator and Redeemer and Sustainer. Sharing who they are in truth and love. Sharing who they are with us in the deepest and most unbearable moments of our lives. For they know we need them to get through all that we are experiencing, or else we will have painful moments to encounter on our own without them. And so, my friends, as Jesus said to His disciples, He says to us as well, I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When times and things are unbearable in our lives, may we realize that the Holy Spirit has come, that the Holy Spirit is present, that the Holy Spirit is within us and abides with us and is here to lead and guide us into all truth. That He will declare what we need to hear when we go through the rough times of life. The question is, will we be open to what He declares? And will we be open to His presence in our lives? I hope we are, for it is only when we are that the unbearable becomes bearable. Amen.